Hi all, how is everyone doing this fine day or night, depending on the time you live? Oh my gosh, that's wild. Legester Vixen here, doing another reaction. I want to thank both No Name Dash JT six, I can't see, KL, sorry, and Jenny Jen 94. Thank you guys so much for this request. It is nursery rhymes. Apparently there's four parts, I believe. Four. So we're going to have fun with these nursery rhymes. Me, I love nursery rhymes because I never heard them as a kid. But then when I did hear them, I went to the originals, so I got to see and just dig in deep of all the original nursery rhymes and how dark they actually are. And it's like, oh, that's what it is. But other than that, yeah, we will start that in 3, 2. One of these days, I will get used to speaking fast. Today is not that day, though.
Hark! My ears have heard a special talk.
I like that beanie. I'm sorry. Oh, does PlayStation still sell that beanie? Do I have to find it on Amazon or eBay? Because I will find it and I will wear it. Sorry. Distraction.
Slaughtered or salvaged? Hark! My ears have heard a special hurtling. As if it be true, something hath fallen from the heavens above. What is this? Why, it's a DVD. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to go back into the Pauly Shore and Spindly Johnny world of direct-to-DVD, or in this case, more accurately, direct-to-VHS. And I'm willing to bet that out of the 500,000 people subscribed to my channel, only 5 of you have heard of this gem.
I'm about to go really obscure on your asses today. Probably the most obscure I've ever gone, so I hope.
So I've never seen this, by the way. Like, this is all new to me. But it looks so old and I love it.
You're ready. One thing that you should know about me is that I am fascinated by nursery rhymes.
I love them.
Half of them are bloody stupid and make no sense at all. Many of them are weird beyond description but are very catchy to sing along to. And some have ridiculously dark origins that make me question
yes.
why kids sing them gayfully in the playground. And when I was young, and I mean really young,
aww.
My dad had a very quaint collection of VHS cassettes that my sister and I could watch whenever we went over to their house. She had a lot of the Disney Classics collection when there were only like 25 of them to buy, and a couple
yep.
of... Extremely bloody strange ones. Funnily enough, though, the strange ones were
that?
All nursery rhyme-based short movies. A bit of an odd coincidence, but I loved rewatching them, clearly, and I remember 4 of them that she had. BBC's Rhyme Time, which was honestly...
Yo, I'm the keeper of the key. The magic nursery rhyme key.
Bizarre beyond comprehension. There was another that was made for deaf people and had subtitles and a sign language lady at the top right of the
aww.
Video, but I don't remember what it was called or who made it. There was another narrated and sung by British National Treasure Darren Day that was so full of cringe it smells of rotting cheese. And finally, the classic nursery rhymes collection by Longman Videos, which we watched more than any of the others over and over again. It hypnotized us. This was an hour-long epic collection of nursery rhymes with music composed by John Duprez. Sorry if I'm pronouncing that wrong. But he's famous for composing the scores of The Meaning of Life, A Fish Called Wanda, and even TMNT 1-3 in the early 90s. Yes,
no.
I'm not joking. The
compilation
featured the musical talents of all sorts of people, from UK kids TV presenting legend Floella Benjamin to hugely inspirational folk musician Martin Carthy, who also played and sang alongside in one of my favourite bands ever, Steel Eyes Band. Despite the same budget of a tin of soup and made by a handful of people, it somehow had animations, puppets, green screen people, and special effects galore. Look at the special effects.
Mm-hmm.
And all of this considered, and it looking rather well, shit. After its release in 1982, it managed to sell over 1 million copies in the UK. Impressive stuff. It became a bit of a cult classic. But don't take my word for it. Just have a look at the 5-star reviews on the back of the DVD.
Oh?
From the year 2000.
Oh.
About the VHS tape. I'm talking about a UK nursery on VHS today. What the fuck am I doing with my life?
So for the sake of my pathetic nostalgia, but mostly because I want to laugh at it from how cheap, tacky, and budgeted it is, I am now alienating everybody on my channel who doesn't have a clue about anything that I just talked about as I dive into Longman's The Classic Nursery Rhyme Collection. And even if you don't know what I'm talking about, I really do hope you enjoy this as much as I know I will, because this film gets so fucking ridiculous I can't even describe it.
I may or may not sing some songs. Just a heads up. Or say some nurseries, if I know them. I might.
Let's begin.
Ah, I know that cheeky bassoon from anywhere. This must be Humpty Dumpty. But where is he? He's coming.
He's terrifying.
There he is! Ah, my god! If you thought the Kinder Egg was scary, well,
oh my
this
god.
Guy is coming to get you 7 days after you finish this video. Okay, whatever, I'm over this now. Let's just enjoy it for what it is. Oh no, the singing isn't helping. Oh god, quick, just fall off the bloody wall, expose your brain, die horribly, and let's move on.
That was a baritone of a voice.
No, don't play it again. I don't need to hear it again. That was awful. What? Why was that there?
That was him dying.
Okay, next song.
Ugh, Mary, Mary, quite contrary. This shit even bored me when I was a kid. Look at how boring it is. Well, except the bush having a fit. That's a little bit interesting. There's no pretty maids here, me dears. Only death and scorn. The next song begins and it's Jack and Jill Went Up the Hill. Classic stuff. And the instrumental beginning I actually fucking love. It's gleefully played on a fiddle and perfectly complements the acoustic guitar's counterpoint, which could have just been chords, but fuck it, let's just go complicated.
So good!
Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water.
I don't think they did. It looks like they just climbed a few green stairs to me.
Come on, man.
Oh, whoa! They entered light speed for a second there, and they left the realm of physics so quickly that the stairs even followed alongside them. I don't blame you for crying there, Jack. That was very painful. Ooh, Jack. Ooh. Jack, you need to see a doctor. You need to get that monster of a face sorted. The next song is Goosey Goosey Gander, the lovely kids classic about a goose that goes into someone's house and finds a man not praying before going to bed. And so the goose
took him by the left leg and threw him down the stairs.
Jesus, that went from 0 to 100 quickly. I've never seen such a terrifying goose in all my life. The utter fear in this man's face should not be ignored either. Oh no, kids, stop singing. Are you seeing what we're seeing right now? Run away while you still can. Oh, well, okay. Well, you can run away after the obligatory green screen ducks flap around for a second. Watch out for the booth behind them, though. It tends to move around a little bit.
Okay, right quick. Geese, goose, whatever. And they are quite terrifying. Long story short, when we were kids, my brother had gotten bit by a goose. He punched it in the face, and then the whole flock of geese just chased him. It was actually really terrifying.
Next two songs I also found pretty boring as a kid, despite the awesome fact that the kids in the film are moving around a paper fold-up church. That's imaginative for no budget at all. But yeah, it's just...
Girls and boys come out to play.
That song, not very interesting at all, but it's followed by Ring Around a Roses, which now I know is all about the plague, making this entire scene hilarious nowadays.
A tissue, we all fall down.
That's not a cute one.
You're all going to hell, kids.
I must also question the validity of this sound effect. That is definitely not what happens on screen at all. Oh, look, it's the end of the chapter.
Aww.
Yeah, okay, I think I should explain this. Again, in a very imaginative and ambitious move for being made in someone's bathroom, probably, this entire movie's theme is that it all takes place in a book of nursery rhymes, hence all of the fold-up environments and buildings and all the awesome page-turning transitions. In order to not have a constant assault of nursery rhymes blasted at you, the film is divided into the chapters of the book, which play a brief musical piece that is revisited throughout the film with entirely different instruments and orchestral arrangements, alongside a preview of all the songs coming up in the next few minutes. I love this idea, and the piece is goddamn catchy as hell.
Ooh. I don't. Maybe four.
That, but me pissing my pants.
The next song is, well... This is the way the ladies ride. I've never heard of this rhyme, and I've only ever seen it ever on this tape. And the young lady partaking in this song's actions could not be in any more ecstasy. If you want to do this song at home, you basically have to use a baby to show how different people ride horses, you know. Apparently, ladies...
Trit, trot, trit.
Gentlemen, and farmers, well,
gallop.
Ah, no! Calm down, you'll destroy the infant! And it ends by slowing right down with old men riding horses and how they wobble around and ultimately fall off, injuring the horse, killing the man, and that baby could not give less of a fuck about any of this. While on the subject of horses, the next song is another English classic. Luckily, Ride a Cock Horse, with awesome Baroque period instruments and a pleasant if boring stop motion thing that's going on. Nothing really to say here, so let's move on. Dance to your daddy, my little laddie. Dance to your daddy, my little... Oh, no, wait. Dude, no. You do know that's not how you play bagpipes, right? This is embarrassing. You're not playing a keytar, they're bagpipes. What are you even doing? Yes, everyone, dance in circles around the man who has no idea what he's even doing here. And yeah, why not? Rip that poor kid's arms off. Look at his face. He's in total pain right now. Cut it out. Whoa, look at him go.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah.
The next rhyme that follows is known as 1-2 buckle my shoe, which isn't that exciting of a rhyme and not that exciting in this film. It's just pages of a book turning while kids read out each part of the rhyme.
5, 6, 6, 6, 6. 7, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8.
Made them straight.
And everything seems okay until this bit.
15, 16 maids in the kitchen.
One, two, three, four, five, once I caught a fish alive. No complaints here, once again it just does its job fine. But then when we find out the fish bit the little boy's finger and that's why he threw him back into the pond, when we see which finger...
This little finger on the right.
Wait, no. That's not his little finger, and it's not drawn like a thumb because it's pointing straight upwards, so it must be an index finger, so this means that the kid has six fingers. Simple Simon met a pieman going to the fair. Said Simple Simon to the pieman, how did you appear from fucking thin air, you evil wizard? The song after that is Oh Dear, What Can the Matter Be? Another English classic, and one that has a kid in it that mastered Michael Jackson's moonwalk just in time for the Victorian funfair. Immediately after that, though, is Hot Cross Buns with an old guy who is so happy to be a part of this, he's actually kind of adorable. Oh, look at that face. Aww. What a steal. I want to steal him. With his happiness overtaking him, however, what he fails to realize is that yet again, in the same funfair around the corner, the next tune will begin, and he'll be stuck watching a boring load of fucking Morris dancers for a minute and a half. I mean, seriously, no ill will to Morris dancers out there. If you like it, fucking good on ya, it's harmless, but I just don't get it. I don't find it interesting or impressive, and with the constant flailing cloths and jingle-belled feet, it drives me nuts after 20 seconds, let alone a minute and a half. It's a shame because the rhyme itself is one of the catchiest in the film.
I like their feet movement.
Whatever the hell that means, how do you blow a top knot off? But it means that you have to sit tight and watch these unchanging and poorly green-screened dancing bearders for 90 seconds before moving on. Don't worry though, because we quickly end up on the loudest part of the damn film with an angry man screaming at you about the Grand Old Duke of York.
He mugs them up to the top of the hill and bats them down again! Christ on Mike! Now, man! Actually, now we're on this subject, have you ever realised how fucking dumb this nursery rhyme is in the first place?
I mean,
when they were up, they were up, and when they were down, and when they were only halfway up, they were neither up nor down. I mean, first of all, down rhymes with down, so that's not very good, and secondly, fucking duh, right? I mean, what else are you supposed to say? It's not like you can go, and when they were up, they were down, and when they were down, they were left, and when they were only halfway up, they got into a spaceship and fucked off. It's like, you can't say that.
Ugh, now this is boring. Little boy blue, come blow your horn. The sheep's in the meadow, why can't we watch porn? This little shit falls asleep while looking.
I didn't know that was the original version. Version. I can't say version without saying virgin. God, dang it. I didn't know that was the original.
Looking after sheep and nobody will wake him.
Sorry.
Up because he'll cry. That's the nursery rhyme. I mean, grow the fuck up, people. Who wrote this? Do you want your sheep back or not? Then wake this little shit up and smack him through the thinking about crying when he's looking after living beings. I need something a little bit more logical. Hey, diddle, diddle. Perfect.
Yes.
Meow, 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 meow.
I vastly regret everything I said a second ago.
The little dog laughed to sing so small. And the dish ran away
with the roast beef.
The next part, for whatever reason, was like my favorite part of the film when I was a kid. The song is known as Achan Drum. Ever heard of it?
Nope.
Neither have I. But it's here, and when I was younger, I thought that his name was Aching John. The song is about a man that lives on the moon and wears clothes made out of different food. And I will admit that, yet again, the song is one of the best of the film. Extremely catchy and full of bouncy banjos, but why did I like this bit so much as a kid? Looking back, this guy's kind of a creeper.
Oh no.
Put your beefy jacket back on. You aren't sexy. This isn't the time or place for that. There are children here. Think of the children.
Lucy Lockett lost her pocket. Kitty
How?
Fisher found it. Not a penny was there in it. Only ribbon round it.
I'm sorry?
Did you know that nursery rhyme is about prostitution in the 18th century?
Really? Fascinating.
I'm not kidding. Look it up. Seriously, look it up.
I will.
Messed
later.
Up, isn't it?
Wee Willy Winky runs through the town, upstairs and downstairs in his nightgown.
Okay, he's a streaker. That sounds like a streaker. Or a flasher. Like he's having the trench coat just laying out of there.
Rapping at the window, crying through the lock. Are the children all in bed? It's past 8 o'clock.
Well, even if they are, you just woke them up with your yelling, you moron.
Also, you're a kid. Why aren't you in bed? This rhyme is stupid. What follows at this point are a load of quick-fire rhymes that I haven't got anything to say about. Even Little Bo Peep, for as famous as that song is, it's just not that interesting to talk about as well, even with real-life lambs involved.
Aww.
So much potential. Squandered. So let's hope that the next rhyme, Little Miss Muffet, gets the respect and charisma it deserves. Okay, things are okay so far. Nice harpsichord there. Oh, no. There's the cheeky bassoon. Oh, who's coming down? Who is it? Who's coming down? Hey! There it is. There's the fucking spider.
That's
I love
a huge
this
one.
Look at it. It dances along with the cheeky bassoon. That, and it kind of looks like Pingu had dreadlocks and then had half of his head torn off. This spider is worth the price of admission, I tell you.
Okay, so I gotta say, out of all the nursery rhymes so far, that's the best one. 10 out of 4. Right there.
Whoa, did you just see that? Look at him go.
88 miles.
Anyway, we now get introduced to old King Cole, the merry old soul with his pipe and his bowl, and
the sun goes on for 2 minutes.
Jesus, if you think 90 seconds of Morris dancing would be too much, then how about instead 120 seconds of this goddamn mother-humping king waving his arms around all over the place with a bright red half-asleep face like your drunk uncle at a Christmas dinner, while his angry Terminator musicians appear and look like they're gonna shoot up every single person in the room, while the king's terrified and poor defenseless child slave servant sits there too afraid to move and gets stroked on his head like a dog every so often.
Hello.
Would you like that?
No.
Because I don't like any of it. Okay, Yankee Doodle, this one everybody should know. This kid knows he's starring in one of the most well-known nursery rhymes of all time. He's so cocky and convinced he's in the best part of the film that they even give him a slow-mo shot. Dang, look at that swag. But be warned, Yankee Doodle, because it appears as though the foundations of the town as we know it are rupturing and everyone shout.
Okay, the next song here is Here We Go Round the Mulberry Bush. What's the song? How does it go? This is it.
Here we go round the mulberry bush, the mulberry bush, the mulberry bush. Here we go round the mulberry bush in a cold and frosty morning.
And that's it. That's all it is. And they just keep repeating that over and over again using different daily routines as their verses. And, I mean, where's the rhyme?
This is the way we brush our teeth in a cold and frosty morning.
Where's the rhyme?
This is the way we brush our face in a cold and frosty morning.
Where's the rhyme? Hashtag where's the rhyme? This isn't a nursery rhyme! See, that kid gets it. He knows how fucking stupid this whole thing is, so he's not taking it seriously at all and trips up everyone behind him. I love how they decided to keep that blooper in. Keep on rocking on, kid, whatever you're doing nowadays. You could see past the bullshit even more than the adults who made this.
The next song is known as Soldier, Soldier, Won't You Marry Me? And yes, the puppets are goddamn petrifying. And if you don't know the song, here's the basic gist.
Soldier, soldier, won't you marry me with your musket, fife and drum?
Oh no, sweet maid, I cannot marry you, for I have no head to put on.
Yes, this This is a rhyme about a soldier refusing to marry a lady because he hasn't got the right outfit to marry her in. Fair enough, I guess. So she helps him out with all of her grandfather's things until he's fully dressed for a wedding. But then how does the rhyme end?
Oh, sweet maid, I cannot marry you, for I have a wife of my own.
You miserable fucking scumbag. You come in here, tell this lady that you can marry her if you have the right outfit, then watch her slowly give you everything you want and don't bother telling
for
her
shame.
That you already have a wife, and then you just fuck off and steal all her granddad's clothes. What the hell? Did you not care about your wife at all? Are you having affairs all over the place and this is some elaborate scam? Why are kids singing this shit? Ugh, maybe if we go towards the lot more innocent pop
shame.
Weasel, it'll be all okay.
And what I love about this one is not only the adorable thing that actually appears randomly in the song, it's bloody cute, okay? Mm-hmm. Also, this whole rhyme is sung in a Cockney accent.
I also love how in this shot, the kids are supposed to activate pop guns and they malfunction, but instead of just redoing the shot, they just leave the footage of the guns failing and the kids all looking confused and disappointed. Why the hell did you keep that in? I don't know, but it gave me a laugh, so I'll let it slide. Oh hey, look, it's more Cockney kids singing another rhyme. Okay, I think we're done on the Cockneys for now. I wonder if the next song will be just as adorable as those accents.
Okay, those are really cute. I like that. Oh? That's traumatizing. That's terrifying. I wouldn't want to see that as a little kid. What? Excuse me?
Oh, stop this. I feel unclean.
What the fuck am I meant to make of any of this? Look at it. It's hideous. Why is the music so off?
Wait.
To make of any of this? Look at it.
Okay, so I'm trying to. I want to go for my pocket knife. I'm not. Okay, so pinky up. All of these are like this with the pinky up, and then his. Why is his hand like this? Excuse me. Oh, that's. Doing yoga. Okay, that's what we're doing.
It's hideous. Why is the music so ominous? I mean, I get that he's a crooked man, but
I feel bad now. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. That was very rude of me. I didn't realize he was crippled. I'm sorry.
No, stop. Die in a hole. Look, can we just speed through this part and get it over with? I really don't like it. Sweet! King biscuits!
The weird levels are starting to take its toll on me. I don't know how much I can handle anymore.
Here's another rhyme. Ding dong bell. How does this one go again?
Ding dong bell. Pussy's in the well.
Kitty's in the well.
You know,
pussy.
Yeah, thanks, Walter Jr. That guy's great. He's there whenever you need him.
Of course it's a cat. And in this song, this Jordan underneath looking motherfucker tried to drown the cat. I'm not kidding. What the actual hell? This is just.
And they have
and
a real cat.
At all as well. Perhaps we should just move on. Oh no. This is probably my least favorite nursery rhyme of all time. Old MacDonald had a bloody farm. Yeah,
with
he had a farm. What happened to it? I bombed it because I hate this song so much. It doesn't rhyme, it isn't catchy, it's repetitive as sin, it goes on far longer than it has any right to, and it's just lazily written and lazily performed, whoever does it. I'm sorry.
I never thought this time 10 years ago that my job in the future would involve dissecting how awful old MacDonald had a farm is.
And this here is no different, and what makes it worse is the constant kid chorus screaming out every single verse and chorus, the still images that never change, and the fact that it goes on for nearly 2.5 minutes.
Okay, that's really long.
Here. This scene sucks, and it ruins the central part of the entire film.
Well, I've now certainly decided this is a little bit too much for me to handle for just one video. Yes, everybody, I'm afraid to say that my deep and meaningful analysis of this pure work of art here went on a little bit longer than I was anticipating, so it will have to be a two-parter. But if you enjoyed it,
yes.
Tune into part two next Sunday, where you can further watch me rip to pieces this classic beloved nursery rhyme collection. Apart from old MacDonald, he can stuff it.
Before I go though today, I'd like to send a huge Aww. Thank you to all of my Patreon supporters.
Thank you
guys,
to his Patreons, even though this was like 6 years ago, but thank you guys.
And I really can't thank you. enough for what you do and how you support the show. It means more to me than I can even feasibly describe. All of you on the screen, you help out the show in a way that you really, really have.
Music's catchy, I'm sorry.
If any of you out there are thinking about having a look on how to support the show even more, well, yes, have a look in the description. It'll be at the end of this video. It's completely, and I can't stress this enough, 100% optional. Nobody is holding a gun to your head. You don't have to do it at all. You don't even have to look at the page. If you don't know, just looking at the page is enough to make me thank you to the high heavens and back, because it means so much to me. And until part two of this video, if it's your birthday today or watching this video, happy frickin' birthday to you, and please remember to stay beautiful.
Subscribe. I saw Lion King. Ooh. Not today, but I will be doing that one. Okay.
I have a question for you all today. What happened when you forced Caddy to sit down and watch a load of nursery rhymes from a direct to VHS independent short movie made in the UK in the 1980s? Such a bath that this video needed to be a two-parter series, so if you haven't seen part one, click down here to see it right now. And if you have seen it or you don't really care, well then, here's a brief summary of what happened. Together now, we bombed the farm, we killed an egg, we caught the plague, he lost his arms, we punched the place and pink, we died a goose, then threw us down the stairs, a spider danced, we all got shot, a king got drunk, exposed the pit, we ran away, we drowned a cat, and then the egg killed us. So hey, did you notice how that song didn't rhyme whatsoever?
Yeah.
Like a few of these songs in this classic nursery rhymes collection. I'm looking at you. This is the way the ladies ride. Here we go around the mulberry bush, Aiken drum, Old MacDonald. You aren't rhyme, so stop lying. I really do need to carry on with this though. The halfway point of the video is here. The worst song ever has just ended, so what's next?
Ooh, catchy. With a gent. Okay. I might have to get my pillow as well.
What dark place am I heading for with this? This is the house! Okay, this song is This is the House That Jack Built. Think of it like, I don't know, there's a hole in the bottom of the sea. Yeah, it's actually kind of a story with a much catchier melody and rhythm, and it rhymes. I used to love this bit as a kid, and the fact that the key keeps getting higher the more that is added to the song is so great. And the man singing gets so into what he's singing here, it's actually kind of hilarious. Like, he puts on stupid voices.
They kiss the maiden all forlorn.
And even fucking screams in joy in places.
The dust, the dog, that worried the cat, that killed the rat, that ate the mole.
It's constantly shifting as a nursery rhyme, and is always fun to listen to despite clocking in at 2.5 minutes. And I replayed this bit so much as a kid, I now know it off by heart 3 times faster. This is the farmer sowing his corn, that kept the cock, the crowed in the morn, that waked the pistol, shed and shorn, that married the man or tat, and torn, that kissed the maiden all forlorn, the milk, the cow, the crumpled horn, that tossed the dog, that worried the cat, that killed the rat, that ate the malt, that lay in the house that Jack built. B-I-N-G-O, B-I-N-G-O,
B-I-N-G-O,
and Bingo's house was green screen. Okay, what's the point of making your dog bark if you aren't going to use the barks in the song, or at least sync it up? Ugh. God, look at these cuts. Ugly, ugly.
Ugly! Ugly!
Oh my god, Baa Baa Black Sheep. Everybody knows this classic. I wonder how they'll pull this one off.
Baa Baa Black Sheep, have you any wool?
Yes, sir. Three bags full. One for my master, one for my dame, and one for the little boy who lives down the lane.
I'm just gonna. That was terrifying. That was very terrifying. I was not expecting that.
Jesus!
Ah, well, the next bit is.
This little piggy went to market.
Hang up. Firstly, that's not a little piggy. That's objectively a fucking huge pig. Secondly, why is this so unsettling? That is the creepiest way to sing a nursery rhyme I've ever heard in my life.
This little piggy had roast beef. This little piggy had none.
I think it's worse too because of the squealing that the pig's doing. What is this? Nursery Rhymes, a horror edition? I don't like horror.
This little piggy cried, wee, wee, wee. I can't find my way home.
I also have to point out that the word
home
in this nursery rhyme actually rhymes with
home.
I think this song actually should go like this. This little piggy lost the dictionary. This little piggy couldn't read. This little piggy was a gluttonous waste of air. And this little piggy couldn't think of any other word that rhymes with home.
I thought I was going to say, and this little piggy needs a pee.
And this little piggy cried, wee, 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 my parents are bacon and sausages! Okay, to continue with the piggy theme, here's a cute and catchy short rhyme.
To market, to buy a fat pig.
Oh!
Home again, jiggity-jig.
Okay.
And then you just repeat it, but with a hog and jiggity-jog. And in a very unexpected visual gag, when the farmer gets the pig, he takes the pig home in the trailer. But then when the farmer gets the hog, the horse takes a ride in the trailer and the farmer rides the hog home. That's very cute and it gave me a laugh, so fuck off. Where's the next one? Patty cake, baker's man. Oh, no, wait. Are we talking about Who Framed Roger Rabbit patty cake? I bloody hope not. And hey, check it out. It's the adorable old hot cross buns guy from earlier being extra adorable. I mean... dude, come on. The song asks that you
bake me a cake
as fast as you can.
So please tell me, what the fuck is that? That ain't no cake that I've ever seen. It looks like a hot water bottle covered in dandruff.
Dandruff for everyone!
And you know, I love how they continue the acoustic guitar from this song and smoothly transition to the next song, Little Jack Horner. And can you blame me for a second for finding this the scariest damn picture on the entire video? What's up with the aggressive lighting? Why is he in the corner? What?
Can we talk about why it looks like his shadow is stabbing him through? Like, I understand the shadow down here for his waist, hip, this area. I understand that shadow. And this is very aggressive. But right here, it looks like he's, like, it looks like it's going through his, between his side and his arm, so it's like one of those fake deaths, but it still looks like the shadow's stabbing him. And what are you eating? Why is it the same darkness that is? Did we cross into Kingdom Hearts? Is that heartless? And there's no life in his eyes, they're just black. Okay, I'm sorry.
Scariest damn picture on the entire video. What's up with the aggressive lighting? Why is he in the corner? Why does he look like Sharon Osbourne? What the fuck is that shadow supposed to be? It's like the fucking Babadook. And you know, the rhyme is dumb anyway.
Eating a Christmas pie, he put in his thumb and pulled out a plum and said, what a good boy am I.
Why did he say that? Who says that at any time of their life ever?
Are you a good boy?
Ooh, dog food. What a good boy am I.
Who sticks thumbs into pies anyway? Is there some sort of art to pie eating that I'm not aware of?
Peas, porridge, hot. Peas, porridge, cold. Peas, porridge in the pot, 9 days old.
Cool story, bro. Cool story, bro.
Oh, it's the same table.
Okay, I'm getting a little bit weirded out by no backing instruments, I must be honest. Something is quite ominous about this whole thing.
Taffy was a Welshman. Taffy was a thief.
That's racist.
Taffy came to my house and stole a piece of beef.
Okay, then.
For whatever reason, I also loved this part of the video as well. It's a rhyming story about a boy having shit stolen from him while he's out of the house looking for the guy who stole it, and it's just so delightfully dumb but just rolls with it. Plus, the page is constantly going back and forth to show each character missing each other in their houses is a pretty awesome idea.
I went to Taffy's house. Taffy wasn't in. Taffy came to my house and stole a silver pin.
What a cunt!
I went to Taffy's house.
I'm sorry, you went where?
To Taffy's house.
To whose house?
Taffy's house.
Need a glass of water there, mate.
Like any slimy thief, Taffy gets his comeuppance by having a marrow bone that he stole from someone being thrown at his head while he was sleeping. Serves him right. Ah, another classic.
Sing a song of sixpence, a pocket full of rye. 4 and 20 blackbirds baked in a pie.
Who doesn't know this one? You know, the one where
the king was in his counting house, counting out his money.
Well, no, he wasn't. That's the same pose he was in when we were talking about the 4 and 20 blackbirds baked in a pie. He's just staring at a pie right there.
The maid was in the garden, hanging out the clothes.
That's... They're lemons.
When down came a blackbird and pecked off her nose.
Okay, you look me in the eye and tell me that that isn't scary to hear as a kid. This song gave me fucking bird phobia. Ornithophobia for years because I
thought avian phobia?
When and how a bird would sweep down and rip my nose off. Ugh, terrifying. I love birds now, though, and this little fucking Charlie trying to bite my nose off is just laughable.
That's the best you can do.
Don't say that.
This next part of the video just gets on my tip.
I had a parakeet once. She was not that lovable. She drew blood. I may or may not have PTSD.
It's Ave Maria at the same time as Little Tommy Tucker.
Little Tommy Tucker sings for his supper. What shall we give him? White bread and butter.
Who thought this was a good idea? Also, Tommy Tucker is a stupid rhyme anyway. Little Tommy Tucker sings for his supper. What shall we give him? White bread and butter. How shall he cut it without a knife? How will he marry without a wife? What? Firstly, what has cutting bread with a knife have to do with getting a wife? And also, yes, he can marry without a wife, not just a lady wife. Why should he have to sing for his supper anyway? Why is it so dark with only one window? Has he been locked in the cellar for being a family embarrassment? Too many disturbing questions are arising from this, so let's just move on to Polly, put the kettle on. Hello, stylist.
Yes, madam.
Remember when I asked you to curl my eyelashes and tint them a little bit? You glued eagle wings onto my eyes, you bastard! Hickory dickory dock, followed by three blind mice. Nothing really to say at all, actually. It's pretty good stuff. However, I find it very funny that the mice have to walk around holding each other's tails with a cane and glasses, but yet they still need a degrading literal label hanging off of their ears just in case you couldn't see that they were blind. Bless them. You could have written anything on these signs and they'd never even know. How depressed. Couldn't see that they were blind.
Give me a second. Why does this look like eyeballs down here? I should not see that. They all look like eyeballs. It looks like they're looking at me. Okay, I'm done.
They could have written anything on these signs and they'd never even know. How
the fuck are we?
What's the next song then?
A was apple pie.
Was it?
Well, technically it's AP, but continue.
B, bit it.
C, cut it.
D, dealt it.
E, et it.
Et?
Fought for it.
Wait a second, wait, no.
Yeah?
What are we fighting for?
Food.
E just ate the thing. Are we eating another pie?
Yes.
Or the vomit of the last pie?
Both.
Oh, just give me another pie, please. Give me another pie. Thank you. And yeah, these are pork pies.
Okay.
Apple pies suck.
G got it.
H had it.
I inspected it.
J joined for it.
K kept it.
My precious.
Because I just opened it.
R ran for it.
S stole it.
D took it.
That's the same thing.
U upset it.
V viewed it.
W wanted it.
Oh really? You want this?
Yes.
You want that?
Yes.
Want
I want tall.
And you want this?
And I want to eat it.
You want all of this?
Yes.
You got good taste, you have. Good taste.
X, Y, Z, and ampersand.
This isn't a letter, you twat. We then get to see the same school church thing from earlier in the film, but with a different lighting and colour scheme. It's pretty nice, honestly, to look at. Shame about the songs, though. We have Mary Had a Little Lamb and Seesaw Marjorie Door. It seems to say the more actual classic nursery rhymes that everyone seems to know are the ones in the film that are the least interesting to talk about, which is a little bit of a shame. I mean, they do the job that they're supposed to do, but that's really all you can say. I don't have any complaints either way. They work, at least. Well, maybe the green screening could use some tweaking. I mean, where did she go there? And I guess it's a little bit funny to speed this bit up. Hey, lady.
Hi.
What do you know that I don't? Oh, that the next song is perfect fodder for immature idiots.
I love little pussy.
Ha! Seriously though, that cat is adorable. You're a lucky kid. Well, I don't mean lucky that you're holding a kitten that cute, but that it hasn't decided to claw every inch of your face off yet.
Oh, that too, yeah.
What you're exactly like as a person if you were born on a particular day of the week. It's like horoscopes, except approximately 58 times more inaccurate and pointless.
Monday's child is fair of face.
Very lucky there.
Tuesday's child is full of grace.
Any Tuesday-born atheists out there today? Nah, of course not. The video told me that's not true. Let everyone born on a Tuesday praise as hard as this motherfucker over here.
Wednesday's child is full of woe.
Ah, sorry, Wednesday kids. I'm afraid you're gonna need to go and get some therapy.
Thursday's child has far to go.
What does that mean? The kids born on Thursdays are never where they're meant to be. Ever. That's awful.
Friday's child is loving and giving.
Well, personally, I know quite a lot of Friday-born dickheads, so that doesn't really mean anything to me.
Saturday's child works hard for a living.
Good old Saturdays, you keep working hard. Not those Saturdays. I don't like those Saturdays.
And the child that is born on the Sabbath day is bonny and blithe and good and gay.
Oh yes, that's me! Sunday child represent! Anyway, on to the next song.
There Monday was child. A girl, and she had a little curl right in the middle of her forehead.
Why is her bow so bad?
When she was good, she was very, very good. But when she was bad, she was horrid.
I had a little nut tree, nothing would it bear, but a silver nutmeg and a golden pear. The king of Spain's daughter came to visit me, and all for the sake of my little nut tree.
Pussycat, where have you been? Didn't you know? She went to London to look at the Queen.
Pussycat, I frightened the little mouse under her chair.
Welcome to planet Earth, everyone, where little mice are nearly just as huge as the Queen and could conceivably sit upright on the royal throne.
I'm gonna say that that the kitty's voice was very...
I'm sorry?
I'm gonna give you that stuffed animal. Okay. You know what? For Pokemon fans, I'm bringing out Eevee. What? Caddy, what are you saying about this? Exactly. Where are you going? Can you go back home?
Oh, Captain Carthy is back saying London Bridge is falling down with Isla Saint.
No. That nursery rhyme is evil. It's evil.
All and collected acoustic renditions I've ever heard, and the idea for the video is actually probably the most imaginative so far. Looks like a normal drawn bridge, doesn't it? Eh? Well, you just wait.
Wooden play will...
Yes, it's playable! Oh. How awesome is that?
And okay.
You keep rebuilding the bridge with different artwork on the cards representing the different materials, and altogether you have an adorable and clever part of the film. And straight after London Bridge is fixed, it catches on fucking fire. That's fantastic.
That is burning.
Yep, it sure is. I've never seen such a convincing fire in all my life. What's after this page transition, then? Oh, God.
I don't know how I feel about that.
Farm was enough. Not this song, too. I fucking hate the 12 Days of Christmas. And I will also never understand why people like it. The same goes for you, Shrek.
On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me.
Let me guess.
Five onion rings.
Oh, I knew it.
Just stop. It goes on for exactly an hour and a half, never really changes once, makes the fifth day slower for no goddamn reason at all, and I think that the people who made this short film felt the same way, because the visuals of an unfolding load of cubes with pictures of each gift on each day of Christmas, the fact that every single collaborator is involved in singing, and the awesome multi-layered instrumentation that changes after every day sequence is sung makes it bearable. But at the same time, it needed all of that stuff, otherwise this would have been easily the worst part of the film. It's still going on day after day, as slow as hair down a sinkhole, and I really just don't like it. Moving on.
As a person that I know about.
Still going on.
I know about doing that. That's my job. I work with my father in handyman repairs, and that's no fun. Plumbing can be fun. That's no fun.
tear down a sinkhole, and I really just don't like it. Moving on, how about this one?
There was an old woman who lived in a machine. She had so many children she didn't know what to do. She gave them some broth without any bread, then whipped them all soundly and put them to bed.
Nursery rhymes are messed up. I don't like them anymore.
Someone needs to call the fucking social services on this old bag. She has way too many kids, lives in a fucking shoe, neglects feeding the kids, and then smacks them for no reason.
Pow!
Why are you not frightened?
Why? You know what? Nope. I was gonna say, why is she look preggo?
The kids and then smacks them for no reason. Why are you?
It's not preggo. It just looks it. I'm sorry. My mind's not there.
You not frightened?
I'm
then
sorry.
There's a quick poem about a tired, lazy, and hungry kid going to bed, and then another one about a fat northerner called John who
went to bed with his trousers on.
Well, who can blame him? He's his own man, that John, good old John.
Hey, my God.
One more slightly creepy rhyme about a family killing a rabbit to wrap a baby in. Yeah, yes, I'm not joking. And we come back to what I think is the best bit of the fucking video. Old Mother Hubbard. Most people know the rhyme as this.
Old Mother Hubbard went to the cupboard to fetch a poor dog a bone. When she got there, the cupboard was bare, and so the poor dog had none.
But for some reason, I guess mostly because this dog marionette is one of the sweetest and funniest puppets I've ever seen, they just keep it going and throw every single bit of logic and reason out the window. For instance, what happens straight after verse one?
She went to the baker's to buy him some bread, but when she came back, the poor dog was dead.
I don't even know whether to laugh or scream. Where did that come from? That's a fucking dead dog. Look at that vacant, empty gaze.
So, why was she starving the pooch? Why did she wait till the pooch was about to die to go get it some food? I'm sorry?
Poor thing.
She went to the fridge to buy him some fruit.
Wait, no! You go to the parlor and buy him a coffin! Your fucking dog just died! Or does the dog pull this shit all the time?
But when she came back, he was playing the flute.
Okay, you know what? I'd be as disinterested and unsympathetic as Mother Hubbard as well. I don't...
Okay,
it's clear
never
that
mind.
Fucked around all day. What a legend.
She went...
Okay, so he was just playing dead. Like... You know, when dog owners teach the dog to die, and they pow, and then, they make that sound effect too.
And the tailor's to buy him a coat, but when she came back, he was riding a goat.
Okay.
I'm looking at right now.
She went to the barber's to buy him a wig, but when she came back, he was dancing a jig.
All right. Stop it, Caddy.
Quick. Move on to something else, quickly.
I actually... No, that was like the best one right there. I hate this nursery rhyme.
When the bough breaks, the cradle will fall. Down will come baby cradle and all.
Oh, no, that was lovely. Thank you, nursery rhyme video. I really needed to hear that today. The thought of a baby on a branch in a cradle, and then the branch breaking, and the baby being crushed by the weight of its own cradle has kind of set me on a downer now. I'm not laughing anymore.
Oh look, more sadness. What does the robin do when snow starts falling?
He'll sit in a barn, keep himself warm, and hide his head under his wing. Poor thing.
Jeez. Is it possible that we're actually coming to the end of this movie? There's not really a reason for everything to take such a melancholy turn unless it's gearing up for a slow and comforting ending sequence. Twinkle, little star. Oh, yeah, okay, this must be the last one. I mean, this must be the most popular nursery rhyme of all time. Why didn't they play it earlier? Saving it for the end, that's why. It's nice, honestly. A better alternative for a sleepy kids nursery rhyme movie than to end on fucking... Yeah, that. And with that delightful storybook closer, the classic nursery rhymes collection is over. And how does it hold up?
Yeah, technically, if you want me to pick it apart piece by piece, well, it's one of the most hilariously dated and budgeted direct-to-VHS independent short movie UK things I've ever seen in my life, and I love rewatching it just to laugh at it. But honestly, I think it's brilliant. Seriously, absolutely brilliant. And you know what I also think it is? Timeless.
This was shown to me and my sister, I've shown it to my girlfriend's kids, and I plan to show it to any grand relatives if that should ever happen.
Aww.
It really is a classic cult UK family film that I'm convinced any kid would be hypnotized by as much as I was, purely because of how confident it is in its delivery. You just get lost in all of the creative and imaginative ways they literally bring a storybook to life, and yeah, the effects are pretty shocking and stuff, but it is what it is, a product of the time, and so quaint and charming that you can easily look past it. And the music? Oh, Lord! The music is incredible, I'm not even joking. All of the musicians are spot on, the vocalists bring their own unique spin on well-known favorites, and the dozens of instruments being used from the medieval Baroque period to classical and even country and western not only means that the music feels like it could have been made at any point in time, but has the energy and human-like soul that something like this desperately needs. Especially if you're going to cover something as overdone as nursery rhymes, put your own spin on it, make it authentic, and with putting a spin of making the song sound like they were being performed by someone from the period that these songs were probably written in is clever and immaculately constructed as well.
I do appreciate that.
You rock this one out, man. Congratulations. No two songs feel alike, and there's no modern tripe like Wheels on the Bus over here.
And oh my fucking god, you tell me, would you rather sit with your kids and watch something like this?
Tom, Tom, the Piper's son had a picker.
So I used to watch, not this per se, but stuff like this with my nieces when they were infants.
Showed you that was released on February 19th, 2017. This thing here, 1982. And you tell me which one is the most timeless and has an actual soul and doesn't dumb down lyrics and make grating pop songs that all sound identical and go on.
Yeah, they do.
Time as this film with ugly and horrible fucking CGI. You can call me a nostalgic idiot, but you know what? This, the classic Nursery Rhymes collection, it gets the salvage today. Until next time, if it's your birthday today watching this video, happy frickin' birthday to you, and please remember to stay beautiful. Speaking of, I'm not feeling too beautiful myself.
Aww.
I know what to do to fix that.
Be beautiful.
That's
all right.
Yeah, okay, got it, yeah. Great, now I'm only vaguely beautiful. And
aww,
that is all thanks to the sponsors for today's video, Dollar Shave Club. Now, the outtakes will be on in a second, guys, so please hang on. But you might want to listen to this, because the Dollar Shave Club is an awesome online service that ships you some of the best razors I've ever used to your door every single month, and for the same pricing as disposables. And if you head for the description of dollarshaveclub.com/caddy, you will be able to try a 1 month trial and get any single razor for $1. $1. No hidden fees or commitments.
$1.
And you can use it to cancel whenever you want to. You might as well steal them, it's so cheap. And you see all of this like awesome BioShock Infinite stuff.
Shave butter.
That's only part of what you can expect to get from a subscription. You can get body cleansers, shampoos, conditioners, shave butter, all sorts of stuff. And if you want a recommendation on a razor, well, yeah, I...
Okay, I can't read because I'm looking at all the, put the razor down, please, sir. So we have mint cedarwood, which is nice, sage, black pepper, but because I didn't see the B, and for some reason I mistook the A for an I, I thought it said sage lick pepper. So, I mean, I'm not above licking pepper, I'll lick some pepper, but my tongue would probably burn. Again, Vixen can't read.
An honor to help promote them. Thank you so much, Dollar Shave, and also thank you so much for watching this video and of course going into the link if you decide to click on it. Really helps the channel out like you wouldn't believe. So thanks very much, and if you want some outtakes,
that's
well,
the music.
Hurrah, everybody, thank you.
Oh,
I missed it. The crumple, the horn, the toss, the dog, the worried, the cat, that killed the mat. Killed the mat, fuck!
Love me. Love me. Alright, this is
Hey everybody, and thanks so much for clicking on this video, but before we begin,
I'm just going with this, so yeah, I think this is Anyways, we're going to keep it going.
And I'd love to thank the sponsors for today's episode, App Hunter, which is an app on iOS and Android, links in the description below for easiest access, where you can get rewards like Amazon gift cards, Steam cash, Xbox,
ooh,
PSN, Netflix, iTunes, points, tons more, by downloading and playing the latest games and using them as much as you want until you get the rewards you desire. It's really that easy.
And don't forget to use my invite code Caddicarus for extra bonuses. It's very important.
The more you use App Hunter, the more you spend with particular games, the greater the rewards are. So I recommend you check it every single day, and the quicker it'd be for you to put some money towards some of the fantastic looking releases coming out this year, like Kingdom Hearts 3 or something.
Aww.
You know, if it comes.
I'm not doing that because I have any hatred towards Kingdom Hearts. I love the franchise. Mike looks so serious.
Is that at all?
And it's even more important that you remember to go to the links in the description below. Everything's important today.
Thanks again.
Okay.
Enjoy the video.
I just prefer Kingdom Hearts 2 more over number 3.
I'm dreaming about nursery rhymes. That isn't a good thing, is it?
Ah, don't be a cock. Of course it is. Nursery rhymes are the best thing that's ever happened to this beautiful planet Earth we live on. And I dream about them every single night.
I will shoot your mum in the face!
Okay, dreaming about nursery rhymes is definitely not a good thing.
I really need to get this shit out of my head and move on to something else.
But what?
So you know what that means then, don't you? Oh yeah. The nursery rhyme VHSs are back.
Greetings and salutations, my beautiful people, and welcome to the Caddicarus show. I'm excited to do the nitty gritty of deciding whether or not things deserve to be slaughtered or salvaged. And
my God, sir, calm it down.
And what are we doing today? Nursery rhymes. One of the parts of human history I simultaneously love and really don't understand with how they got away with singing about prostitutes and the plague on the playground. Who remembers the first nursery rhyme VHS I looked at a while ago? I mean, okay, it wasn't the highest viewed video series I've ever done on this channel, and this video won't make as much sense if you haven't watched that one yet, so go and do it, please. But everyone seemed to really enjoy me ripping into the childlike innocence on display. And I'm even more surprised that when I talk to people online or in person, they also seem to remember that very same nursery rhyme VHS, and they couldn't believe that I decided to dig out something so obscure. So now I'm gonna do it again.
Yay!
I'm not joking. I'm drowning in these things. I've got so many fucking direct-to-video DVD nursery rhyme videos and shit that it's coming out my ass.
But that was your mouth.
I've been dying to do this video for ages now. The last time I dived into the world of obscure British direct-to-VHS nursery rhyme cassettes, God, even saying that makes me sound like a fucking serial killer, I took a look at the classic nursery rhymes collection by Longman Video, an entirely timeless and joyous watch, but mostly at the expense of the really low budget and the fact that it was cheesier than Papa John's fingers.
I make fun of it, yeah, but I still very much love it and it is a huge part of my childhood. But that wasn't the only nursery rhyme VHS that my nan had in her collection whenever me and my sister went over.
Oh?
There was also this one. I think I had a condition. I couldn't stop watching nursery rhyme videos. Is there an illness for that? No? Well, that's good because it means I'm not going to die, which means I can keep talking about these.
Yay!
Don't worry, though I'm not insane, there is a very important reason I wanted to talk about this one today. If you watch the classic nursery rhymes collection, despite it having the same budget as a used condom, you can see the huge level of...
I almost missed that from how fast he was speaking. I almost said how speedy he talked. Freaking you. My poor virgin ears.
Blood, sweat, and tears that were poured into making it. Special effects, puppetry, an amazing multi-genre original score with some of the UK's best folk musicians. It has it all, and that's why I love it so much even today.
But this one doesn't even fucking care.
Even the title of it is shit. Classic Nursery Rhymes. That's it. That's what it's called. I know the Classic Nursery Rhymes collection isn't that much better, but at least it implies this is a collection of classic things that you'll want to keep to yourself. Here it's almost like this one just took away collection
you.
And the, because they thought that title just wasn't boring enough. Also, here's some wrinkly old man ass. Have a nice day, cunt. And once you begin, it unfortunately
why?
Doesn't fare much better. I still love watching this DVD, don't get me wrong,
is she,
but I
is
love
she
it for
kicking
different
the
reasons
bell?
Above the other one. This is just so lazy and shit in comparison to the other one that it leaves me stunned the more more I watch it. I mean, even the fucking introduction to the tape is terrible. It's just a scrolling collection of screenshots, and to accompany it, they just picked up the nearest plastic keyboard and played the first preset song on it. Are you enjoying this yet? I hope so, because it lasts another 4 hours.
And if you weren't as stunned as I was re-watching that for the first time in years, then you will be stunned when you see our host for today.
Hello, I'm Darren Dave.
Oh, there he is! That, ladies and gentlemen, is UK national treasure Darren Day. Don't know who he is? Lucky you. This is him in 1991, chilling out with a cow and wearing a official Olympic shirt with the wrong colours and the rings the wrong way up. And he will be the only, I repeat, only voice you hear in this whole tape. Yes, no other singers and no actual instruments either, as you'll hear from the first song, Humpty Dumpty.
Really?
Yep, hear that shitty
okay,
plastic
I
keyboard backing
know about
track?
This
That's
one.
In the whole short film. No original folk renditions or actual acoustic instruments, this. And in the other Nursery Rhyme VHS, Humpty may have looked like, yeah, that, but at least he didn't just fall off the wall like a deflated balloon. There's a dead egg. On to the next track.
Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow.
But that lamb's fucking green. And, well, can you see the immediate next issue with this Nursery Rhyme VHS? I don't think it's too hard to notice. If you think there'll be any actual imaginative ideas, animations, puppetry, green screen, or anything compared to the other one, nope. Every single track of this VHS has a few dedicated paintings from a handful of artists, and that's it. I wouldn't mind too much, but look at Mary's face.
It made the children laugh and play to see a lamb at school.
They are definitely not laughing. That looks like they're swallowing the soul of Mary.
Hang up, the teacher's pissed!
Why Mary loves the lamb, you know, the teacher did reply.
She replied with what?
Why Mary loves the lamb, you know.
How did she say it?
Mary loves the lamb, you know.
You're trying to tell me that voice came out of that lady?
Loves the lamb, you know.
And yes, there's a few artists on show in this video that aren't too awful, all things considered, so actually have a really unique style, but if this is how we begin the movie off with some of the messiest art I've ever fucking seen, then you need to try very hard to impress me later on, obscure unknown UK nursery rhyme director VHS movie. Okay, it's alright. It's
Bembry.
Not terrible. Ride a cock horse, everyone knows this one. I just missed the fucking stop motion animation from the last video I looked at.
Okay, I really need to stop comparing this to the other one. It's just never gonna match up to it. If it has done-
You're not gonna quit comparing. If you've done it the first how many ever songs, you're not gonna stop comparing. Just that's the rule.
This, enough times by this point, that just means every single rhyme is going to have a stupid fucking still image instead of anything creative, imaginative, funny, or anything like that, so I just need to stop complaining. Have you ever taken away the word horse from the title of that last nursery rhyme? Ride a cock.
Ring a ring a roses, a pocket full of poses, a tissue, we all died from the plague. Simple Simon is next, yep, very simple indeed, except for that funky ass keyboard solo. I also didn't realise that Simple Simon kept going on after verse one. What's all this about catching a whale in his mother's pail or pricking his fingers on a thistle that made him whistle? Didn't he just try to get a pie but had no money and couldn't? What's all this pointless fluff? Oh, speaking of fluff. Bah, bah, black sheep, have you smoked a joint? That sheep is high as fuck right now. Whatever he's having, I'll take 20. Whoa, okay, wait, what?
We're gonna be... I'm gonna be a good girl, because I'm goodest to girls. I was gonna say something, but no, we're gonna be good.
I'm watching this for like 3 minutes and we already have an interval with the same shitty keyboard backing track from the very beginning of the video.
God, what have I got myself into? You know, I should feel nostalgic watching this back, but I just don't. I must have watched this as often as the other Nursery Rhyme video just because it was shorter than the other one. It was easier to pop in and watch, so... Why I don't feel any kind of childhood memories flooding back right here. I just fucking hate this. This is terrible.
Dance to Your Daddy is ridiculously brief and doesn't do anything interesting. And then, this follows on to the only rhyme I remember from this entire video because of how it traumatized me when I was a very young child. Who killed Cock Robin? Good question, but what a needlessly dark, depressing, and outright nasty rhyme to just throw onto an innocent child watching Darren Day singing. In fact,
I mean,
it's so
I like
serious,
the art,
he even stopped singing here. No joke. Listen to the music. It's like he's giving a fucking eulogy.
Who killed Cock Robin? I said the sparrow. With my bow and arrow, I killed Cock Robin. Who saw him die? I said the fly, with my little eye, I saw him die. Who caught his blood? I said the fish, with my little dish,
This entire segment of the video stuck with me for years. It's long, the artwork is really good, but Christ if it's a little bit threatening in places.
It is traumatizing.
This somber for the rest of the film, and all I'm left wondering is why the fuck the sparrow shot the poor bastard in the first place. Why is everyone trying to figure out the funeral arrangements when the murderer is sitting right there smugly showing off how great he is at killing robins? Let's add a bit to the rhyme, shall we?
Who'll arrest the culprit? I set the moose. I'll wrap him in a noose. We support the death penalty.
And you want to follow that up with hey diddle diddle? You can't do that, movie! You can't just ignore everything that happened 15 seconds ago and act like this is a family-friendly fun time for everyone in the family.
In fact, why am I even calling this a movie? Nothing ever fucking moves in it. It's all just a load of still images, so I'm not going to call it a movie anymore. From this point on, I'm going to call it a... stilly.
I like it.
A stilly.
10 out of 4.
The next rhyme I've never actually heard of before. I saw a ship a-sailing, except it talks about mice on the decks and a captain duck with a pack on his back.
I really think I heard it.
This because I just don't know it. But I will ask whose idea it was to record Darren Day farting in the bath and use it as a backing track.
I saw a ship a-sailing, sailing on the sea.
Next up is Dr. Foster Went to Gloucester, except with a backing track that sounds straight out of fucking Parasite Eve.
Dr. Foster went to Gloucester. In a shower of rain.
I'm not a fan of some of the darker turns this stilly is taking. Some of these rhymes are really fucking ominous and I don't like it.
He stepped in a puddle, right up to his middle.
Doctor, that isn't a puddle. That's a bloody lake. There's ducks in it. Get some new glasses and fuck off. I don't want you operating on me ever. This little piggy went to market, another classic, except the tape decides to take another dark turn and uses a backing track I swear to God I heard in Amnesia, a machine for pigs.
This little piggy went to market. This little piggy stayed at home.
I seriously, seriously don't like some of the music choices here and the way Darren narrates over them. They're needlessly freaky. And I think the unmoving images just makes it all the more unsettling. I just keep waiting for something to jump out at me or one of the pictures to start sliding towards the camera. Something needs to happen. Come on, the suspense is killing me! Plus, the end of this rhyme is that the last pig cries wee 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 because he can't find his way home, but he's already at home, so I don't think the artist got the memo.
And this little piggy cried... I'm on my way home.
Okay, I don't know why, but that really cracks me up, the way he ends that nursery rhyme. It's like he forgot what the words were and just made up something at the last minute and pulled something out of his ass. Wee 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 wee.
That was funny. Oh?
What?
Hello?
What? Why aren't you playing? Go! Oh.
Part two?
Yeah, another interval already, just in case you need a break from the 4 minutes we just watched. Okay, then on we go to Wee Willy Winky, not much to say here, and then...
Good fucking Johnny, what is that thing?
Is that supposed to be a cat? Someone needs to get a refund from the taxidermist.
Pussycat, where have you been?
I went to...
Pussycat has seen some things.
London to look at the Queen and found a huge gross mouse picking his nose with a disgusting belly button sitting underneath a chair made of hemorrhoids. Is that how the rhyme goes? Also,
yes.
Give a raise to whoever thought it was a good idea to put Wee Willy Winky right before a pussy. Why the hell did you do that? Oranges and Lemons is next, okay? That's fine enough, I guess. But I'm more interested in how Darren sings the ending bit about kids having their heads cut off.
Here comes a chopper to chop off your head.
Oh, don't worry, kids. He made it sound like the most charming thing in the world. The sick bastard. All right, the next track is Old King Cole. And on the original Nursery Rhyme VHS I talked about, this bit went on for a while because the song itself goes on for a while. Old King Cole calls for his fiddlers, drummers, trumpeters, etc. So you'd think if they were going to add a load of random bullshit to Simple Simon earlier, it would make a load of sense if they actually did the full version of this track. But they don't. This lasts for around 10 seconds. All the King's servants look like they belong on the Muppet Show. And then we move on to the one and only... There was a crooked man. Remember how disturbing and creepy the original Nursery Rhyme VHS was with this rhyme?
Please,
well, I hope
worse.
You do, because Darren Day forgets the connotations of an arthritic old man living on his own stealing change and instead puts the most soul into his singing than in any other point of this stilly.
There was a crooked man, and he walked a crooked mile. He found a crooked sixpence against a crooked style.
I also really do think someone should take this cat to the vet and wrap this abusive old bastard up and make sure that the cat actually caught a mouse, because that just looks like he ripped off someone's scrotum to me.
Come flab it, cat. It's late. No. No. Hot cross buns. Hot cross buns are good.
Hot cross buns. One a penny, two a penny, hot
cross, anuses.
Yes, we have another lovely painting by whoever this artist was from Mary Had a Little Lamb, and half the shit here just does not look right. This looks like the start of a fucking Bush Tucker trial on I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here. We have kangaroo anuses, koala tits, bull penises, and she really loves eating all of them by the looks of things. I don't mean to harp on the art too much, but look at how sloppy and disproportionate everything is here. That saddle is half the size of the fucking bike. Her right foot is inflated. He's eating his own hands, and the artist left the background hill outlines on top of the trees in the foreground.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Piano.
Sorry.
Yep, another interval, and we follow into three blind mice with literally nothing interesting to say, and then boom, here's some atmospheric synth.
If all the seas were one sea, what a great sea that would be.
Okay, I don't know this one. It's all about if all the seas, trees, and axes were all together and made the biggest, bestest versions of a sea, tree, and axe, which isn't really a rhyme, but whatever, I'll take it. I don't know it, so that's cool enough. And there's more than one picture here, so at least that's a little bit interesting.
If all the men were one man, what a great man that would be.
They'd be a strong man.
I don't think you thought about that sentence, did you?
Also, if this guy is so great, then why does he decide to cut down the only tree in the world, starving himself of his only oxygen supply? He's a fucking idiot. And if all the men made up this great man, does that mean Alfred the Great joined in as well? Would that make him Alfred the Great Great? I'm bored, let's move on.
What's a little boy's made of?
Well, you see. When a man and a lady love each other very...
And pray tell, what are little boys made of? Frogs and snails and puppy dog tails, and girls are made of sugar, spice, and all that's nice. This is just blatantly untrue. I know guys that love makeup and girls that love puppies. What the fuck is your point, Nursery Rhyme? Yeah, I'm moving on now.
Thank you.
Little Tommy Tucker sings for his supper. What shall we give him? White bread and butter.
It sounds so ominous! Like... The synthesizers just don't know. No. Why did I have you on my shoulder? I don't know. When did you go on my shoulder? I don't know.
I haven't got anything to say about that. Once again, the music was fucking horrifying, but what the hell is going on with that face? Mixing up with the subject matter of a guy locked in a room begging for bread and butter, and all in all, I feel like I'm watching a David Lynch movie.
How will he be married? Without a wife.
During his wife moves, accuses him. I'm sorry. That's not funny. I do apologize. This was. Apparently, it's true. I'm sorry that that happens. It's called irony.
I am done here. What's next?
Yankee Doodle. Fine. Whatever. It's serviceable. But I'm very concerned with this image over here. He sees a young boy riding past on a horse, and the first thing he thinks is,
yep, time for me to yank my trousers up and get my bulge out.
And so with that, we end up at one of my personal favorite nursery rhymes. This is the house that Jack built. The rhyme where you start from the bottom of the rhyme, but keep adding more to it as time goes on, and the key keeps going up. Like, there's a hole in the bottom of the sea, but just a lot better in my opinion. Now to go back again,
Doggy.
The first nursery rhyme VHS I looked at, this is one of the best bits, and it was extremely theatrical and energetic. But what do we get on this fucking stilly?
Tossed the dog that worried the cat, that killed the rat, that ate the malt, that lay in the house that Jack built.
He sounds as bored as I am right now. Come on, Darren, emote! You're singing a great nursery rhyme. You should be more like me.
This is the farmer's own, his corn that kept the cock, the crowed in the morn, that waked the pistol shed and shorn, that married the man on tat, and torn the kiss, the maiden all forlorn, the milk, the cow, the crumpled horn, that tossed the dog that worried the cat, that killed the rat, that ate the malt, that lay in the house that Jack built.
That face is terrifying, by the way.
Yes, another fucking interval later, and we end up-
I don't know why I thought I saw Scooby-Doo. That was not Scooby-Doo. Watch your falling. Don't fall on me. Or don't fall off me.
Sixpence, where nothing really happens, and then we end up on Little Bo Peep. Okay, fucking seriously. Who decided to draw Bo Peep as depressed as this? Little Bo Peep has lost her sheep and then got liver failure. Onto Hickory Dickory Dock with a mouse that sounds like someone screaming as they enter the depths of hell.
The clock struck one, the mouse ran down.
And don't forget the utterly pointless twinkle noise. When nothing actually happens on screen. And then there's another quick fire rhyme here.
Cock-a-doodle-doo, my dame has lost her shoe. My master's lost his fiddlestick and knows not what to do.
Okay, I know he's saying lost, but it sounds like he keeps saying lust. Or is that, that's just me, right?
Is that just me?
It sounds like you're saying lust. Okay, that last part sounds really bad. I'm sorry if I ruined that for anyone. I'm so sorry.
Except her shoe is right there, and he's holding his fiddlestick, so what the bloody hell's the problem? Polly put the kettle on. Meh. Followed by patty cake. Meh. But at least there's a few interesting details here. Firstly, that the child that wants the cake has been allowed to shittle over the floor, and the baker stepped on the baby's feet because he looks like he's about to murder the poor thing and doesn't want it to escape.
And after that, we have another fucking interval. I mean, I'm not joking. This is how fast the rhymes come and how often the intervals are. It's almost like the people that made this thought that the kids wouldn't be able to withstand the amount of content being pushed in their face, and they had to take a break every 5 minutes, even
but
though...
But then they should have made a part two!
I mean, come on, pick up some speed, you stilly!
Oh, great, over the hills and far away. Now, to go back once again to the first VHS, this part of the movie was fucking great. I mean, I hate watching the Morris dancers, but the music is so fucking good and played with so much soul, and it's so catchy. Just listen to it here. And now I hope you're ready, because here's the Darren Day interpretation.
Over the hills and a great way off, the wind shall blow my top knot off.
Like, I don't get it. You have a late 80s zero budget thing.
It sounds very muted. Like, it's just... it's going here and just kind of slowly declining.
That tries as hard as it can, yet with more technology at cheaper costs in the 90s, they just do not care here. How much more bored could you sound, Mr. Day?
Met old Dame Trot with a basket of eggs. He used his pipe and she used her legs.
You used your what and she did what?
He used his pipe and she used her legs. Tom saw a crossfellow was beating an ass.
Oh, I bet he was, the little slut.
Next rhyme, here we go.
Two legs sat upon three legs, with one leg in his lap.
Okay, I get it. I'm following so far.
In comes four legs.
Yes! How did that go again?
In comes four legs.
That is the best
okay.
theme I think I've ever heard for
That's
a dog
great.
Entering a room.
Stop. Okay then, what's next? Is this Rockabye Baby?
Rockabye Baby.
Oh, you don't need to tell me the rest. I know this one. On the treetop.
Father's a noble man, mother's a queen.
Okay.
That's not how it goes!
Betty's a lady.
Who's Betty? And what's she got to do with Rockabye Baby? And who's this Johnny over here?
Johnny is a drummer.
Oh, I didn't expect him to actually be called Johnny.
Oh.
Fair enough. You can move on, Johnny.
As I was going to St. Ives, I met a man with seven wives. Each wife had seven sacks. Each sack had seven cats. Each cat had seven kits. Kits, cats, sacks and wives. How many were there? Going to St. Ives.
Oh, I know this one. It's a trick question. There's only one person, him. He's going to St. Ives. The rest of the ladies he walked past, they were just going past him.
But you're 10 seconds late.
No, 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 no! The answer's one! One!
There's a bomb in the treasure!
Ah! Oh!
I didn't say Simon Says.
Oh, well, fuck you, Nursery Rhymes. I'm done with you for the time being. Seriously, though, I actually am done with it for the time being. You see, this might be a little bit shorter than the other Nursery Rhyme collection I talked about, but I had more to rip into here than I ever expected. So this video went on much longer than I anticipated, and it's going to have to be a two-parter. So tune in 2 weeks' time on Sunday, and it's not going to be done next week because I'm going to be in Canada at cons, where I hope to see a few of you guys there and say hello. And that is when we shall carry this on to finish it. We're only halfway through this masterpiece, after all, so we're going to just have to see where it goes from here. So until then, if it's your birthday today while watching this video, happy freaking birthday to you. Please remember to stay beautiful, and I hope I can tell a few of you that you're beautiful at the con.
Aww.
For arriving at the con.
Okay.
Being at the
I'm not cutting Evie. I have a knife. I'm cutting the plastic off of Evie. I have a knife. Because my in-law would have said, Vix is a murderer. It's like, no, I'm not. See, cut the plastic off of Evie. No stuffed animals were harmed in the making of this video.
Yay, 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 yay. Subscribe.
Thank you so much for watching this video, everybody, and special thanks to all the names on screen today that have helped support this channel via Patreon. I can't apologize enough, guys, for not having part 2 done by next week, but like I said, it just won't be possible. I'll be leaving the house on Wednesday, catching the flights on Thursday, not gonna be back until like Tuesday or something, so yeah, it's just not gonna happen. I'm really sorry, but I'm gonna be working on it as soon
Amy,
as I
calm
get
down,
back, so
please
do stay tuned.
Calm
I
down.
Hope you enjoyed this part for what it was. And special thanks to the top tier supporters, Omama 2, Basil, Patrick Ferguson, Andy Ellis, Robert Alamsha, I Have a Portal Gun, Gamerman, Exopaz, Kyle Way, Thomas Olson, Mills Kahai, Alicia Knightley, Super Spyro Fan 2010, Daniel Leon,
Jay like
Knives,
music.
Carsten, Mitchell Reed, Tiago Pereira, AD Thornton Smith, Oblivion Rising, Noxious, Ellen Realplea, Kirsten B, QB, Nathan Young, and Nicole Ganara. Thank you so much, every single one of you.
Last one.
Gentlemen, do you have an uncle? Good. And did he always tell you things that his dad told his dad about bodily health?
No.
Good. Of course it's not accurate enough, but you know what it is? Hims, the service that have sponsored today's video, so thanks very much, and go in the description below to check it out. Because what do they do? Well, it's an online service all about helping men deal with embarrassing body issues. By talking with real doctors through Hims, you can get...
But I'm not him. Oh, it's Hims. Okay, with an S.
From your head to your...
I'm still not him from Powerpuff Girls.
That's completely normal, but it's also silly not to do something about it. But with Hims, you can get the same science-based and effective treatments. Go to the description below right now
at forhims.com/clinic
and get started with a visit to a virtual doctor. And I can offer you guys a month's trial of the comprehensive hair kit for just $5. That's it. So thanks again to Hims for sponsoring. Please check them out in the description below.
Ooh,
and
something
you can
tasty.
Trust me with pharmaceutical stuff. I am trustworthy. I'm completely trustworthy.
Evie, what's going on with your ear? Stop it. Stop it. What's going on with your ear? Ooh!
Hello, my duckies. So I bet you're wondering right now, what the fucking wobbly willy is going on right now? Well, I'll tell you what. Look at the title of this video and you'll see. This is the second part of a two-parter episode.
Ah.
And before you all shit the bed, yes, I do know I said I was going to get this done last week, and I'm really sorry I didn't, but here's the thing. I got home from an amazing trip out to EGLX in Canada the weekend after that first part of the video went out.
Hey, Canada!
I'm not in Canada.
But an amazing time in meeting a shit ton of you amazing people. No matter what I did, I couldn't be protected by an attack of jet lag combined with getting sick, so I physically could not get the video done in time even if I tried.
Either way, I'm okay now, and I'm back.
I'm 5 years late, but I'm glad you feel better.
In case you missed it, here is what happened in the last part of this two-parter.
She sounds so bored.
Altogether, now
we faked a shirt, a lamb with green, we shot a bird, we smoked a joint, a doctor drowned, a big scream, a wheelie went before a pussy, a cat got stuck, we sniffed his ass, we ate some tips, we laughed, a kitty, and his pants, a baby shat, and a lady couldn't find a shoe that was right there.
Ooh.
If it's Phoebe's birthday today while watching this video, happy frickin' birthday to you, and please remember to stay beautiful. Ah, oh, it is Phoebe's birthday!
Aww.
That's when I decided to film this on Phoebe's birthday. Happy birthday, Phoebes.
Aww.
So we just figured out the riddle of the man going to St. Ives, so what could possibly be next?
Okay.
Oh, this isn't very nice. I've already been to one dark place, I don't need to go to any others.
Jack-
Okay, yeah, when I was younger, this painting was, well, rather horrifying. This could very easily be the cover of a physical release of fucking PT, but why is it in pitch blackness? Why is he leaping over a flame? Why is he wearing blood red tights? Why does he look like he just slit someone's throat from behind an alley and made a devilish escape? This picture raises far too many questions and I hate it, so on to Lucy Lockett, the nursery rhyme that is seriously honest to God about prostitution in the 18th century, and then we move on to...
Bloody fucking bumbags! Another interval? We just started! Darren, I'm holding you personally accountable for this! I know you didn't edit this, silly, but look at you, it's definitely your fault.
The next song is...
Peas Porridge Hot. Peas Porridge Cold.
You know, a big group of people sitting around waiting for a stew of split peas to sit around for 9 days before they eat it. Sounds good to me. I don't remember the last time I had so much fun at a ritualistic mass suicide. And then we move on to a cat came a fiddling. I don't know this rhyme myself, and I must be honest, that cat is definitely fiddling with something, but I don't want to know what. And then we pan over to one of my favorite creatures on planet Earth, a bee.
I like bees.
Bees. So yes, this rhyme gets a big old check mark from me. A big old tick. A for a big tick. But hey, the mouse is supposed to be marrying the bee. How do you think that wedding night will go?
Come over here, love, I'm ready for you.
Are you kidding? Your stinger made me very sore last time.
I'll take it over it.
The next track is Handy Spandy Jacka Dandy, the kid who loves plum cake and sugar candy. And I know he looks like he stole them from the shop, but don't worry, the rhyme says that he didn't.
It's not classed as stealing when the owner of the shop is dead, is it?
Also, I'm immediately in love with the backing music and have nothing else to say. I must also give another pay rise to the sick bastard that decided to put A Cat Came A-Fiddling right before Handy Spandy. What are you trying to say here? That A Cat Came A-Fiddling Handy Spandy Jack a Dandy? What a fucking creeper. Next up is not Rock-a-bye Baby, but Hush-a-bye Baby. That's why that last rhyme wasn't correct. And even though you never see the baby fall out of the tree, I find it very dark and a little bit sad that the poor little thing is so happy to be in the tree, not even realizing that in a few minutes it'll come crashing down to the ground and die. They say ignorance is bliss, but I'm not sure that applies here. Next track. Ooh. Out of proportion old woman half the size of her house that definitely didn't miss arm day. What looks like an old man's welly boots stuck out of the chimney. This must be the hot cross buns artist again, and you know you're in for a fun time when the start of the music sounds like the start of the theme for Psycho Mantis in fucking Metal Gear Solid.
There was an old woman lived under a hill.
Why is it so creepy?
And if she's not gone, she lives there still.
What?
What is it with this tape and strangely ominous rhyme?
Why does he say that in such a creepy way? Why is this music making me feel like that woman is watching me from my back garden window?
What's the point? Isn't this rhyme kind of obvious in the first place? If she's not gone, she lives there still. I mean, isn't that kind of fucking redundant? You might as well change the rhyme to, there was an old woman lived under a hill, and if she still lives there, then she still lives there. It's complete fucking trash.
And this is followed by Goosey Goosey Gander. I'd say something about the rhyme, but I already did in my first ever nursery rhyme video.
But
it's a pretty frightening story of a goose that comes to your house and murders you if you don't pray to our Lord and Saviour.
He died for all our sins, you know, buddy.
So yeah, no big deal really. On to the next one. Okay, not quite yet. Another interval later, and we end up on If All the World Were Paper. What a great paper that would be. I like this rhyme for as stupid as it is. But
oh, Peter Piper.
Real, the best thing about this rhyme is the guy having a field day on the keyboard.
If all the world were paper, and all the sea were ink, if all the trees were bread and cheese, what should we have to drink?
Plus, if all the world were paper and the sea were ink, it would all sink in the end. Little Miss Muffet is next, and do you think we get an awesomely adorable puppet spider jiggling along to the song?
Of course not.
What are you, a floppy old dick?
Of course we don't get that. Instead, the spider just appears, and Miss Muffet just disappears. Great. Okay, then
okay.
What's going on in this innocent scene here?
Where are you going to, my pretty maid? I'm going a-milking, sir, she said.
Okay, all right, a little bit presumptuous, a bit forward, I suppose, but
we've
just started. Let's see where this goes, and there's no rhyming yet. But again, we've just started. Let's give it a chance to kick off.
May I go with you, my pretty maid? You're kindly welcome, sir, she said.
Okay, well, I mean, he did ask, and she did say yes, so there's nothing quite that wrong yet.
Will you marry me? Yes, if you please, kind sir.
And you...
Did y'all just meet, though? Have you known each other for a while? This is back in the olden days, so y'all couldn't have no snugglies going on before then? No snugglies?
You said yes!
What is your father?
He doesn't even know who your dad is! Why are you being so cool about this weird man?
What is your fortune?
Look, he's trying to get into your money already!
My face is my fortune, sir, she said. And I can't marry you, my pretty maid.
And now she tells him she has no money and he backs out!
Nobody asked you, sir, she said.
And she's okay with that!
I'm just gonna let that speak for itself. I don't know when that piece of shit was written or why it was classified as a nursery rhyme when every sentence ends with my pretty maid and she said, but you know, either way, I'm extremely uncomfortable and I hate it.
That's just as bad as the one where the maid was trying to get with the soldier who was wearing her grandpa's clothes and then he said he had a wife. I'm not cool with that. This guy wanted to marry her for her fortune that she didn't have, and so he backed out. I'm still not cool with that. It's like, bruh. Sorry, I shouldn't say that. Dude, with the absolute heck.
Mary, Mary, quite contrary, is at least a little bit more normal.
Oh, that's
shame
cute.
About filming the edge of the paper there, though. I've been taken right out of the immersion. Now I thought I was in real life. Yay, tongue twisters, I love... Yay, tongue twisters, I love these. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers.
If Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled pepper, where's the peck of pickled pepper Peter Piper picked?
I think the real question we need to ask, though, is if Peter Piper had two eyebrows on each eye and elf ears, why isn't he living in the forest? I must...
Okay, that's great. I made me drool. I was about to turn it back on, but I don't need spit water on my laptop.
Also bring your attention to his much bigger and more muscly right arm. I think Peter Piper pulled his pickled pepper a bit too much. The Grand Old Duke of York is next, but aside from the climbing of the hill going from this in the original Nursery Rhyme VHS to, well, that, it's also worth saying that his 10,000 men are already at the top and the bottom of the hill because the proportions are so fucked, so you can't make it look like they're halfway up and so either up nor down because they are up and are down. The only way this crappy VHS can make it look like the men are climbing up and down the hill is by making them walk right off towards the captain's feet.
Another into the later!
And we see that the next load of rhymes sounds suspiciously like the scene selections of a porno DVD. And we end up at Old Mother Hubbard, one of my favourite bits of the original VHS I looked at because of the creatively hilarious
right.
dog marionette just going nuts the whole time. And of course, the awesome music, but here we just get Darren. Bloody fucking Darren! Sounding as bored as always and just reading off one verse after the other while the same 3-second keyboard loop plays, and honestly, I just feel sorry for the artist who drew all of these paintings because he or she had to paint like 10 of them all in a row, but they stay on screen for like 2 to 3 seconds each, and Darren doesn't seem to sound like he gives a fuck reading the rhyme out that the pictures were featured in the first place. I'd be pissed about that. Yeah, like this lady.
Come, let's to bed. Says Sleepyhead.
Yep, I know how she feels right now. What's more interesting to me, though, is that on the back of the box for the DVD specifically, this is the only rhyme featured with a weird punctuation error. Come, let's to bed. And I was so angry about this when I saw it that I decided to have a look for more information about classic nursery rhymes with Darren Day on Google so that I could complain to the company, only to then be given...
Some results may have been removed under data protection law in Europe!
Because I guess there was some kind of Watergate conspiracy behind the creation of this DVD, and I think the upside-down, wrong-coloured Olympic rings are actually the symbols representing Darren Day's sex cult. So we move on to Punch and Judy. I don't really get the appeal of laughing at an old woman being domestically abused by her husband with a big bat. And then we move on to Seesaw Marjorie Dorr. Now, I must give props to the guys making this stilly because there is actual animation here, but last time I checked, this isn't how seesaws worked. This VHS seems to think they work more like this.
Ah! Oh!
I like that.
Me too.
I don't think I should be asking what's going on in this picture.
Rubber dub dub.
Oh wait, don't go on just yet, Darren. I know this one. I'll join in with you.
Rubber dub dub. Three men in a tub. And how do you think they got there?
That's not it. What?
They all jumped out of a rotten potato. It was enough to make a man stare.
What?
This next rhyme pretty much gets all of it right. 1, 2, buckle my shoe. I've already talked about this one in depth in my last nursery rhyme video, and this one isn't too bad, to be fair. And then
but...
we go on to...
What?
You know what?
No, what?
You know what?
Oh, fuck. Hold up.
Yes, another interval because you can
Queen
never have enough
too.
Mid-movie snacks
oh,
and probably
birds.
Need the toilet
the
every 5 minutes
crows.
From the Coke you're drinking. And then we're on to the Queen of Hearts, not mentioned in the last video, to be fair. But it's not that interesting. And then we get two little dicky birds with Peter and Paul, which I call bullshit on for a few reasons. Firstly, here's the rhyme. Two little dicky birds sitting on a wall, one named Peter, one named Paul. Fly away Peter, fly away Paul, come back Peter, come back Paul. So yeah, there's only one rhyme in here, wall and Paul. And the other rhyme is Paul and Paul. Lazy. Secondly, watch how the birds in this fly away. You can still see the outlines of them. They haven't gone anywhere. They've just gone slightly translucent. The cock crows in the come on, don't give a flying fuck. And I think the technical term is morning wood. So the next song is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, Once I Caught a Fish Alive. Nothing really wrong here either. In fact, it's probably better than the other VHS because the kid has 5 fingers instead of 6. Next up is 3 young rats in
hats.
And all these other animals that went out for a walk but then went home because it rained. I don't mind this rhyme, actually. It's silly and charming enough to be memorable, and Darren's narration works perfectly with the absurdity a little bit.
Okay. Be positive, let's bring it back!
Well, I wish I could, but this hasn't got much more going on with it. It's fine. And then we have one more interval, and luckily, it's the last one! I Saw 3 Ships A-Sailing is next. I know the melody to this one, but never really heard the lyrics. How does it go?
What do you think was in the bed on New Year's Day in the morning? 3 pretty girls were in the bed.
Oh god, Little Boy Blue. This is one of the more boring parts of the original VHS for sure, but that is a fucking Michael Bay movie compared to the static, unanimated feature of this here. Plus, it's seriously lacking in a Darren Day who should be fake leaning on the painted fence waiting for the cow to steal his watch. Wait a second. Darren? Why are you hanging around in a field with a sleeping young boy? Don't you look at me like that! Even so, it's still such a boring rhyme presented in such a boring way, so I can't say anything more than...
Will you wake him? No. Not I. Or if I do,
then I will die.
And then this is followed up by the Old MacDonald Had a Farm of this tape, London Bridges Falling Down. Yes, there's no Old MacDonald on this, so automatically it gets a point over the other VHS, but that still doesn't mean that Darren Day's adaptation of London Bridge is any better in comparison. Do we get the awesomely creative House of Cards set up or anything? No. We get boring, static, fading images. Whatever, I'm used to it by now. But what I'm not used to is how this just keeps going on and on. Add on for 2.5 minutes. It's the longest part of the entire stilly. The melody and chords just repeat over themselves every 10 seconds or so, and every time you think it's going
I'm
to
sorry?
End, it just keeps on going. They go through the traditional list of things that they rebuild the bridge with at first, you know, wood and clay, bricks and mortar, iron and steel, and instead of ending there with stone so strong after all of them, we get more pointless fluff added to it.
Build it up with silver and gold, silver and gold, build it up with silver and gold, my fair lady.
Great, thank you for extending the rhyme longer than it ever needed to be. I think I'm just about done here, so on to the next rhyme.
Silver and gold will be stolen away, stolen away, stolen away. Silver and gold will be stolen away, my fair lady.
Okay, are we stopping now? Good, so on to the next rhyme.
Set to man to watch all night, watch all night. Watch all night, set a man to watch all night, my fair lady.
God! Okay, you've found something that fixes the bridge. You've got someone to watch it all night in case someone steals it. There's nothing else you can add, is there? No? Are we good to go? Fantastic. So on to the next rhyme.
Suppose it's magic.
Thank God we're nearly at the end. The north wind...
That didn't make me jump. I was expecting that.
Off Blow, a slightly somber song to close off this kind of video, like the last one, actually. And then we move on to the grand finale. Jack and Jill.
Yeah. Jack and Jill. Nothing sad, epic, timeless, just plain old regular, happy, bouncy Jack and Jill. Hmm. It's kind of like ending your classic Nursery Rhymes collection video with Humpty Dumpty or Handy Spandex Jackadandex. You can't do that.
Well, me and my friend Daisy, we enjoyed singing them.
The cow never fucking sang.
If you'd like to see them all again, just rewind the tape.
Ha! The joke's on you, Darren, because this isn't a tape. It's a DVD. Bitch!
Bye-bye for now.
And in the most anticlimactic way imaginable, that's how the short film ends. Right there. No fanfare, no encore, no excitement. It just unceremoniously stops. And as you can probably tell, as far as Nursery Rhyme VHS tapes go, I don't like this one too much. It's really fun to watch back nowadays to see how boring it is and laugh at some of the more absurd moments, and Darren Day is always good for a laugh. But the main issue with it is that there is nowhere near the level of timelessness, charm, and character that the other, older, less budgeted one has. There's just
personality.
Nothing really to say about this one.
That one had the most personality. That and, what was the other song? I don't remember. Wow. That says a lot. Evie, don't look at me like that. I'm sorry. But yeah, that one probably had the most personality.
It's shorter than the other one too, but just feels way longer. And don't get me wrong, I did watch this one countless times as a kid as well as the other one, but you know,
very young kids are mostly okay with anything, and to be honest, I don't think this collection is very good or memorable.
That's not true, because I used to watch Fantasia a lot as a kid. In fact, I think one other person that I know actually sat down and watched all 3 hours of Fantasia. I don't know anyone else who watched Fantasia. The first one, not the 2000 Mickey Mouse one. So kids will not sit down and watch just anything. If it talks to them or if it intrigues them, then yes, but they won't just watch anything. So I have
but
to disagree.
Heartless. It's not going to destroy your kids or leave them creatively bankrupt. It just exists. And that's okay, I guess.
But not okay enough for the Caddicarus show. So classic nursery rhymes featuring Darren Day gets the slaughter today. And if it's your birthday today while watching this video, happy frickin' birthday to you, B.E.B. And please remember to stay beautiful. And now I am done with nursery rhymes for a good long while now, so thank fucking Christ for that. I was starting to get sick of all this shit.
Caddy?
But I'm not.
Subscribe. So that was fun. That was a lot of fun. Go back over here and do this and then do this because I want to put the music back on because I like this music because it's very catchy. But yeah, I do thank you guys again for suggesting this. And the suggestion was Five Phoenix Games. Because we all know how much Caddy likes his Phoenix games. Or I just found out recently he's not a big fan of them. But anyways, that will be one of the next videos. Also, Evie, you are adorable. But yes, I will catch you guys later. Ta-ta for now. Bye. Wait, there we go. Bye-bye.